Welcome back, everybody, to Breaking Point across this wonderful country. Yes, this still is the United States of America, even though they want to make it into communist Russia. We are here at CPAC 2021. This is David Zier, and we're in Orlando. We are in real America, right? South of New Jersey, west of the Hudson River, you know? And, you know, there's a free and open exchange of ideas here. We're not being censored. We're not being thrown off of social media today. So this is a great event. We just had Kevin Sorbo on, actor, movie maker, and we have his wonderful wife, Sam Sorbo. If anybody's seen their movies over the last years, they're great with a positive message. So Sam, how are you today?
I'm great. Thanks for having me.
You're very welcome. It's great to have you on the set with us. So you guys have been in business together for a long time, right?
Yes.
You're the wife of Kevin Sorbo. You're a filmmaker yourself, right? You're also a homeschooler, right?
Yes.
How many children do you have?
Three, 19, 16, and 15.
Oh, wow. Those are good ages. So
it's awesome.
I paid for 65 years of school for my four kids so far.
Yes.
I figured it out. So, and, you know, nobody's waiving student loans for us, right? So I just wanted to welcome you to the set here and CPAC. What do you think about the crowd here? It's great that there's young people.
Yes.
You know, they're informed. They dress nice. You know, it's not like MTV, right? It's a better crowd.
It's true. No, they're respectful and lovely, and it's almost like a bunch of homeschoolers, actually. But it's people that are enthusiastic about this nation, and that's important because we have to recognize the value that we have in this nation, of our nation. And the only thing that's putting a damper on all of it is the masks.
It's really wearing on us. I notice a sea change in people's behavior,
too. Yeah, a little bit. And they have all these waivers that you have to sign that you haven't experienced symptoms and you haven't, you know, and so you have to sign this whole thing. What I'd like to see is a waiver that says, I understand the risks. I also have experienced no symptoms. I will not wear a mask.
Yeah.
I refuse to ask someone else to wear a mask for my benefit.
Right.
Because I am taking my own life in my own hands. I'm taking personal responsibility. That's what I would like to see. And I'd love to see how many people show up for that, because I have a feeling you'd get a bigger crowd.
Well, we're in New York, and the lockdowns are brutal and tyrannical. But in Orlando here, too, you know, you have a liberal Democratic government down here. You know, they're enforcing the masks at CPAC and everything. But what I don't understand, if the masks work, then why do the healthy need them? Like, if you're vulnerable...
Because they say, you know, that they... The argument is...
Right.
You might be carrying COVID.
Yeah.
And therefore, you are diseased.
Yeah, but if you're wearing a mask,
argument. You're
protected,
and
thought.
And the problem... Exactly. Right. The other person is protected. But that's the problem, is we're labeling people as if they were diseased.
Yeah.
This is what we did in Nazi Germany.
But this is more about... You know, taking advantage, like, you know, the George Floyd events, the bail reform events in New York City, and the COVID was like a trifecta. It was like a toxic cocktail for the leftist, Marxist, progressivist agenda to, like, take a stranglehold on America, right? So
granted,
all these blue state lockdowns are so severe, but their economies are 11 to 13% unemployment. The red states who never locked down are 3% unemployment,
right?
Like South Dakota, right? And
well,
Florida.
And the infection rate,
yeah,
between California with severe lockdowns and Florida with
same.
Almost zero is the
8.8%.
Same. 8.8%. So can we not follow science on this?
Right.
No,
and
apparently not.
And the death rates in Florida are only like 1/10, 2/10 behind, you know, per 100,000 of California as well, right?
Right.
So,
and arguably we have a more aged population in Florida.
Well, they did a better job too. You know, we have half the seniors are vaccinated. You know, I'm not a big fan of the vaccine, you know.
There
isn't
a vaccine.
Right?
What vaccine?
You still have to be quarantined. You still can't go to a movie theater after you take the vaccine.
You still have to wear a mask after you take the quote-unquote vaccine. The FDA has not approved a vaccine. So if the FDA has not approved a vaccine, there is no vaccine in my mind.
Well, I'm worried.
They can call it what they want, but
Yeah. The
FDA is not calling it a vaccine. I don't know what to say.
Well, Europe's getting together, and they're going to have mandatory vaccines to get a passport and to travel. And
I
I'm
just
afraid
heard that Israel just passed that.
Yeah.
In Israel, that you need a special passport to function in civilized society.
Yeah.
Which is interesting, because it used to be a gold star, right?
Yes.
Now they've changed it into a passport.
Well, they keep
in
moving
Israel.
The goalposts. This was about flattening the curve so our ICUs weren't overwhelmed,
That's
right?
Correct.
And now it's come to, you know, this like a lockstep agenda.
Well,
and it's scary.
I've asked the question, and I only asked the question why slow the spread? Maybe speeding the spread was the way to go.
I feel that way. I think the lockdowns just kicked the can down the road.
But nobody's asking the question, and that's sort of my big problem, is that we have been schooled, not educated, this entire nation. We've lost sight of what education actually is.
Yes.
And so now we're in a place where you can't ask a question unless you do what? Ask permission first to ask a question. So nobody asked any questions. Fauci came out, he laid down the law, he said what he, you know, and everybody just followed directions. And that's what we're doing in this nation now. And I really have a problem with this, because the left is now hijacking our language. They've been doing it for a while. And that's what my book is about.
Yeah.
It's about the complete demolition of our language. Once we lose our language, our language is the only thing standing between us and violence.
We need language, borders, and culture to be defined as a nation. Our kids belong back in school. I see the mental language. And Stanford University says we're going to lose 98 million years of life from the lockdown consequences, right? Which is about 4 times the COVID deaths. In about a minute, tell us about your book, where our viewers can find it.
It's called Words for Warriors. It's up on Amazon, but you can also get it at samsorbo.com. I've had so many people reach out and say they're not shopping Amazon. And so you can get it at samsorbo.com. It's Words for Warriors, Fight Back Against Crazy Socialists and the Toxic Liberal Left.
Yes.
And it's really just a fantastic, fun, sarcastic glossary of all the words that they've hijacked from us.
Yes.
And trying to put a little bit of order back in our language and a little bit of meaning, because I want people to know what words mean. Because if the left succeeds in silencing...
It means nothing, right? Yeah.
Violence ensues. What do you say to a kid who's about to hit... use your words. Use your words. Tell them how you feel. Tell them what's... You know what I mean?
Yeah.
What do we do before we bomb Syria? Typically, we try diplomacy. But the left doesn't like the words. The left doesn't want the conversation.
Well, listen, our education system's under assault. Our kids aren't learning. I'm going to go buy that book. I'm going to order it online right after the show today,
I promise.
So everybody, Sam Sorbo, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having
and
me.
And enjoy the rest of CPAC, and give our viewers one last 30-second message.
Don't put your kids back in school. Home education is where it's at. If you want your children to learn government, then put them in a government school.
Wonderful. Sam Sorbo, everybody. This is David Zier. You're watching a special edition of Breaking Point on Real America's Voice News, and we'll be right back with the great Dave Bossie.